The Castle of Illusion was Miserabelle's twisted playground of trickery and peril. Nothing there was as it seemed. Into the castle entryway strode the mouse with the heart of a great lion, though his knees felt more like those of a frightened kitten.
Behind this door.
Mickey crossed the threshold and emerged once again into the forest. But it was changed somehow. This wasn't the pastoral wood he remembered. Knowing he would need a way to defend himself, Mickey remembered how accurate he always was in the annual apple-throwing contest back home. The signpost was created by Miserabelle, so of course, it had a mischievous streak.
Sure wish that signpost would make up its mind.
Suddenly, Mickey was in another part of the wood. Were these gigantic trees, or had Mickey been shrunk? With a whirl and a flash, Mickey reappeared in the clearing with the playing card. And much to his relief, he was back to his own size, too. Oh. Mickey knew he was closer to Miserabelle now. The very air around him tingled with mischief and danger. Suddenly, Mickey found himself catapulted into the clouds. Thank you. After a short flight, Mickey was back in the haunted forest, but this time with a playing card. Mizrabel taunted Mickey with her cruel laugh, but perhaps she was secretly worried about how close he was getting. With the frights and sprites of the forest behind him, Mickey faced the next part of his quest with renewed courage. Ah, the grumpy old oak tree. Like all of Mizrabel's illusions, he was no friend to Mickey. Gem was finally his. Now it was time for our hero to move on. Exploring the castle halls, Mickey now had one of the rainbow gems that would help him save Minnie. But he knew there were more to find, and the masters of illusion would not give them up without a fight. Mickey emerged into a toy box of peril, another of the witch's illusions. Mickey had to move quickly and carefully, for the cards weren't playing fairly. Now, Mickey knew how it felt to be a rabbit in a magic act. Mickey moved onward into the land of toys, but these playthings were somewhat less than playful.
Oh!
our hero wasn't sure if he was upside down, downside up, or a bit of both. Mickey'd succeeded, though not without getting a bit turned around. Into a new corner of the Castle of Illusion ran Mickey. But what was that odd green box? The Jack-in-the-Box, of course!
Oh, no! And now I'm in trouble!
orange rainbow gem. Mickey's heart swelled with renewed hope, but the quest to save Minnie was far from over. The second rainbow gem was safely gathered, but Mickey had no time to congratulate himself. Another five gems and Minnie were yet to be found. As Mickey surveyed this new world, he noticed colossal storm clouds gathering in the skies. Hopefully, the rain would hold off long enough for him to make it back to the castle. Underground, Mickey wondered what sort of subterranean strangeness he was about to encounter.
Wow! This place is huge!
As Mickey swung past the giant carved duck, he remembered Donald's advice on adventures. Never have 'em. Oh! Mickey wasn't sure just how deep underground he was, but the next rainbow gem had to be there somewhere. Giant splash, Mickey plunged into the underwater depths of a creepy cave system, teeming with hungry skellyfish. The deeper Mickey went into the ruins, the more sure he was that something or someone was watching him. Everything quaked and creaked. Mickey darted hither and yon for safety, but found none. Suddenly, the entire chamber flooded. Had our hero's luck finally run out? You see, this was the lair of the third Master of Illusion. Mickey seeing double? No, there truly were two of them. Gang of these green-gilled guppies. Yellow Rainbow Gem. Reward indeed for such courage and cunning. Mickey thought of Minnie. Once he had all the gems. Mizrabelle was surely shaking in her boots by now. Mickey had the third Rainbow Gem, and he was determined to get the other four. Mickey chanced upon an enchanted mirror. In its reflection, he saw himself, but wearing far more magical clothes. Rainbow Bridge to Minnie would only appear when all seven Rainbow Gems were collected. There was still work to be done. Mickey found himself in a giant library, but he knew Mizrabelle's books and bookworms were penning a not-so-happy ending for him. Oh! Something about that shadow seemed awfully familiar. Mickey was in a realm of dangerous delights and scrumptious scares. All around was a sea of ice-cold milkshake, but not the sort one wanted to dive into.
Thank you.
only safe way to cross was hopping from cookie to cookie. The fourth rainbow gem was there for the taking.
Hey, you! I mean, me! Stop!
Shadow Mickey snuck up behind our hero, grabbed the gem, and made a culinary escape. Why don't you? Usually, Mickey enjoyed tea, but he might just stick to orange juice from now on. Mickey had the distinct feeling he was being lured into a trap.
Stand still, why don't you? Yikes! In case I should see this coming.
Finally, the green rainbow gem was his. Mickey'd endured a lot of taunting from his pesky shadow, so he couldn't resist doing a little taunting of his own. Mickey braced himself for the next sugar-coated shock from this confectionery world. He didn't have long to wait. A gigantic red licorice dragon emerged from the melted ice cream. This was the fourth Master of Illusion. The blue rainbow gem in hand, there were only two more to find. And then Mickey could search for the most precious jewel of all, his sweet. Mickey had managed to secure both the fourth and fifth rainbow gems. But was he running out of time? Could he still get to Minnie before it was too late? His heart pounding, Mickey raced into the castle hall, only to be met by another of Mizrabel's illusions, enchanted suits of armor.
Yup, not as much. These suits aren't very suitable.
Mickey traveled deeper into the castle dungeons. He knew he had to get those last two gems as quickly as he could. Wonders in the treasure room were marvelous to behold, but none more so than the indigo gem. With the sixth gem found, Mickey began to feel that maybe it was Mizrabel's time that was running out.
This place just never stops, does it? Ah!
Azrabel wasn't playing by any rules now, thought Mickey, as he tumbled into a pitch-black castle corridor.
Hey, where'd the lights go?
Emerging from the dungeon, Mickey raced into the clock tower. Having once been a clock cleaner, he knew the moving parts were dangerous. He'd have to be very careful as he made his way to the top. At the top of the clock tower, Mickey thought the danger of being squished was finally over. Unfortunately, he'd thought wrong. The oafish clockmaker was the final master of illusion. Clockmaster's hour of terror was at an end. The final violet gem was Mickey's. Next stop, Minnie. Finally, Mickey had acquired all the rainbow gems. Now he could cross the rainbow bridge and save his dearest Minnie. Onto the castle battlements raced Mickey. An eerie chill overcame him as he beheld the tall tower. He knew it was the heart of Miserabelle's power.
Thank you.
Was Mickey too late to save his beloved Minnie? Or was there still hope?
You are a match for me. Now that would be a castle of delusion. Spectres from beyond the grave, heed my bidding, hear my call. Rid me of this earnest knave, crush his spirit, be his fall. Attack! You still don't know what my castle of illusion is, do you, Mickey? It's a mousetrap. Return to me, my fiendish fools. Circle round ghosts and ghouls. Spin and twist, twirl and whirl. Let your phantom fury swirl. Strike! Pathetic. You dare to challenge me? Me? Fly faster, faster. Glide round and round. Leave him the winch, no safety ground. Curve in, curl out, then wind about. Possess this space, and now give chase. Fly! How foolish can it be, Mickey? I simply cannot lose. Oh, shades of darkness, oh, spirits of night, destroy this wretch with all your might. His true love's beauty is mine to hold. Her youth is gone, as I foretold. Now curse his heart and blind his eyes. Go bring about his sad demise. Show no mercy! So much more to share with you. Apparitions soar from your crypt, confuse his mind, boggle his grip, wind about him to and fro, steal from him all that he knows. End him now! Oh, no, 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 no. This is my domain. Return to me, my fiendish fools. Circle round ghosts and ghouls. Spin and twist, twirl and whirl. Let your phantom fury swirl. Phantoms and ghosts in grim collusion, band together in my castle illusion. Here, hope is but a fatal delusion, and a mouse shall meet his dire conclusion. He must not prevail.
Mirabelle was dazed. But for how long? Suddenly, Mickey had an idea. What if he launched the rainbow gem at the witch? It might be his one and only chance.
Take that!
Time seemed to freeze for a moment before the gem burst into a cascade of rainbow light, filling every inch of the tower.
No! But I wanted to be the fairest of them all!
It was the cruel witch's turn to be trapped and powerless, encased in the spreading light. The terrible spell was broken. Minnie was free at last, and Mirabelle wilted and shriveled back to her true form. Minnie threw her arms around Mickey, and as he hugged her, he vowed never to let her go again.
Oh,
the gem!
The castle was crumbling, but Mickey couldn't see a way out. What was this? Mirabelle was helping them escape? Mickey didn't have time to consider if this was another trick.
Whoa.
Mickey and Minnie each held onto a broomstick and flew for their lives. Mirabelle had wisdom enough to know when she was defeated and why that was so. She had learned that there's a magic more powerful than any she had ever used. Mickey and Minnie knew it well, and even after what she had put them through, They shared its secrets with her. Now, Mizrabel's heart was filled with a different kind of magic. The magic of love.
Aww.
Now, where were we? The end.